The following dramatization is based on the 2015 Oregon Shakespeare Festival production, directed by Joseph Hodge.
To sing a song that old was sung, from ashes ancient Gower has come. Assuming man's infirm disguise, to glad your ear and please your eye. A story of long many a years, forgotten glory, pray it draw near. And that to hear an old man sing, may to your wishes pleasure bring. Lords and ladies, sinners and saints, of high and low degree, the tale of Pericles.
The tale of Pericles. It hath been sung at festivals, on ember eves and holy ales, and lords and ladies in their lives have read it for restoratives. The purchase is to make men glorious. If you, born in these latter times, when wit's more ripe, accept my rhymes, and that to hear an old man sing may to your wishes pleasure bring, I life would wish.
For the traveler leads by many a road, the wind and wave to dare has returned in dreaming of home. Pray the wind blows fair. Lords and ladies, sinners and saints, of high and low degree, banish fleeting worry, now mark the tale of Pericles, the tale of Pericles.
This Antioch, then. Antiochus the Great built up this city for his chiefest seat, the fairest in all Syria. I tell you what mine authors say. This king unto him took a peer, who died and left a female heir, so buxom, blithe, and full of face, as heaven had lent her all its grace, with whom the father liking took, and her to incest did provoke. Bad child, worse father, to entice his own to evil should be done by none. But custom, what they did begin, was with long use account no sin. The beauty of this sinful dame made many princes thither frame to seek her, as a bedfellow, in marriage pleasure's playfellow, which, to prevent, he made a law, to keep her still and men in awe. But whoso asked her for his wife, his riddle told not, lost his life. So, for her, many a knight did die, as yon grim looks do testify.
Lords and ladies, sinners and saints, of high and low degree, mark the tale of Pericles.
Antioch, a room in the palace.
Young Prince of Tyre, you have at large received the danger of the task you undertake. I have, Antiochus. And with a soul emboldened with the glory of her praise, think death no hazard in this enterprise.
Music. Bring in our daughter, clothed like a bride for the embracements even of Jove himself.
See where she comes, appareled like the spring. You gods that made me man and sway in love, that hath inflamed desire in my breast to taste the fruit of yon celestial tree or die in the adventure, be my helps, as I am son and servant to your will to compass such a boundless happiness.
Prince Pericles.
That would be son to great Antiochus.
Before thee stands this fair Hesperides with golden fruit, but dangerous to be touched, for death-like dragons here affright thee hard. Her face, like heaven, enticeth thee to view her countless glory, which desert must gain, and which, without desert, because thine eye presumes to reach, all thy whole heap must die. Yon sometimes famous princes like thyself, drawn by report, adventurous by desire, tell thee, with speechless tongues and semblance pale, that without covering, save yon field of stars, here they stand, martyrs, slain in Cupid's wars, and with dead cheeks advise thee to desist from going on death's net, whom none resist.
Antiochus, I thank thee, who hath taught my frail mortality to know itself, and by those fearful objects to prepare this body like to them to what I must. For death remembered should be like...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.